Ladies and gentlemen, to present the Pledge of Allegiance of the United States of America, Reagan Hubbard.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
That was awful. What a disgrace to our country. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Final Countdown. I'm your host, Alex Altman. Let's get things started today with a little weekend update. For that, here's Mason Choate and Alex Trader.
Hello, and welcome to This Week in Sports, where we say what everyone else is thinking, but would never be dumb enough to say in a public forum. I'm your host, Mason Choate, alongside Alex Trader. Postseason football is right around the corner, and what better gift to give your loved ones than an Ohio State loss? Last Saturday was rivalry weekend across college football. The Michigan Wolverines all but secured a playoff spot when they handed Ohio State its second loss of the season. OHI overrated. The only thing more fraudulent than the Buckeyes' playoff hopes is Brian Kelly's Southern accent.
On the topic of frauds from the South, the Georgia Bulldogs have made their yearly progression from consensus number one team to the laughingstock of the country. Despite bringing in top-ranked classes year in and year out, Kirby Smart's dogs have been all bark and no bite when it comes to Alabama and St. Nick Saban. Saban had a few choice words for the media after defeating the Bulldogs.
I mean, I don't know what you want us to do, all right? I mean, our program, we're 12-1. We just beat the number one team in the nation, and you guys keep talking to us like we're losing games. So I don't know what you want us to do, but we keep winning, and we're not gonna stop winning. Because I don't know what you want me to do, but we're not gonna stop, so quit asking. Speaking of Nick Saban, the New England Patriots are now the hottest team in the AFC after a win over the Buffalo Bills on Monday. Tom Brady, 2.0, aka Mac Jones, completed just three passes in the game. Jones was the walking definition of the kid who did nothing on the group project and still got an A.
Former NFL MVP Lamar Jackson threw four interceptions in Baltimore's 16-10 Sunday Night Football victory over Cleveland. That win marks the second time in as many showings that Jackson has soiled himself in primetime against Cleveland. But hey, it could be worse for Lamar. His dealings with the Browns have come and gone, but most Cleveland fans have been stuck hovering over the toilet bowl for decades.
USC shocked the college football world by hiring Oklahoma's Lincoln Riley to be its next head coach. This move shut down rumors of Urban Meyer becoming the Trojans' next coach. It seems like Meyer needed the Trojans more than they needed him, especially for his next trip to the bar.
One of the biggest moves of the college football coaching carousel so far was Notre Dame head coach Brian Kelly leaving the Irish for LSU. After Kelly was unable to break the news to his players, he asked the team to show up for a 7 a.m. meeting the next day. Yes, 7 a.m. It was reported that the meeting lasted just 2 minutes long, which is approximately 1 minute and 50 seconds longer than Kelly's average.
Well, that's all the time we have for This Week in Sports. I'm Mason Choate. He's Alex Trader. C.J. Stroud isn't winning the Heisman, and Ohio State sucks.
Great stuff, guys. Next up, we will have Katie Beth Hate It and Lauren Spencer in a lip sync battle. Let's see what you got, ladies.
Grandma. Lauren, you can go first.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer walking home from my house Christmas Eve.
Okay, Katie Beth.
I love my grandma. She's so cute and small. I love her.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer.
Your word is girl. Katie Beth?
Girl. Girls just want to have fun. Oh, whoa. Girls just want to have fun. This girl is on fire. This girl is on fire.
This girl is on fire. This girl is on fire.
Your next word is drink.
Let me buy you a drink. I'm gonna take you home with me. People say I got a drinking problem, but I got no problem drinking at all.
Buy your train. I'ma take it home with me. I got money in the bank.
Okay, your next word is sunshine.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Away when she's gone. I'm walking on sunshine, whoa, and don't it feel good? Hey!
I'm walking on sunshine, whoa, I'm walking on sunshine, whoa.
Your last word is smile. Lauren?
You make me smile like the sun, fall out of bed, something about a bird. When you smile, I smile. When you smile, I smile.
You smile, I smile. Oh, 'cause whatever you smile.
I'm gonna be really honest, I wasn't keeping count, but I think Katie Beth is the winner. Thank you guys for joining us.
No show would be complete without a little weather segment. For that, here's Cameron Terrell.
Good evening, everyone. Today's weather for inside the UARC studio would be 71 degrees, half a degree up from what it was 10 minutes ago at 70.5. In another 10 minutes, it's going to be 75 degrees because I turned it up. In other news, NASA has just announced that an asteroid is only going to miss Earth by a few feet. Thank you.
Thank you, Cameron, for that enlightening weather segment. Next up, we will have Max Vanderglass and Sam Dannenberg giving you a little insight into the world of MMA.
Dude, Conor McGregor's the best in the UFC. He could probably take both of these guys easy, right?
It's an easy misconception for MMA fans to not understand how weight classes work. You see, our friend here isn't understanding how small Conor McGregor really is. He's never competed past 170 pounds. Not to mention, the media has built him up to be an unbeatable monster that can walk into any fight and reclaim a title. Both of these are easy misconceptions for unexperienced fans to believe in.
Honestly, wrestling is so weird. Why don't they just stand up and fight? I mean, this is so boring.
Wrestling is a fundamental part of MMA. It's called mixed martial arts for a reason. The arts mix. And just because when a couple of half-naked men start rolling around makes you uncomfortable, doesn't discredit the sport. Wrestling is one of the oldest and most historic sports that's ever existed. And if you would care to learn about how intricate it is to sporting in general and to martial arts, you could understand how interesting the ground game can be.
I mean, if these guys were ever in street fights, like, this would never work. What even is this?
I don't think our friend here has ever seen a real fight. It's called combat sports for a reason. There's combat. These men train day in and day out for years in violence. Violence of all sorts. And just because there isn't a little bit of foam in their hands and a ref right next to them to stop it, doesn't mean they can't easily go in and hurt someone.
I mean, honestly, this reminds me of me whenever I was younger. You know, I'd get in fights, I'd see red on my opponent, and I'd just black out, you know?
No, I don't know. What does that even mean? I don't know what it is about men today that completely overestimate their fighting ability. Long past are the days of Vikings and gladiators. Today, men don't know how to fight. Financial advisors and accountants can say that they see red, they black out, and they're monster in fights. But that's not true. You see, you have to be realistic with yourself. If you want to say things to raise your confidence and self-esteem, more power to you. But be realistic.
You've got a lot to learn. There's time.
Where are you going? What's up?
As a special treat, we will have former Arkansas football coach Chad Morris, Ariana Grande, Taylor Swift, and Jack Black in a Celebrity Jeopardy show.
This is J Jeopardy. Here's your host, Max Vanderglass.
Hello and welcome to Celebrity Jeopardy. I am here with the wonderful Ariana Grande, Taylor Swift, Chad Morris, and Jack Black. We're gonna get started today and we're going to, I'm gonna ask you guys a question. Y'all are gonna have to beep the buzzer. Whoever does it first after I finish asking the question is gonna get a chance to answer the question. But if you get it wrong, the other team gets a chance to steal. Chad Morris, you understand that?
You know, Alex, I think that your name is Alex, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I think that I hired the best teammate in all of college football. So I'm very confident in what we're going to do today.
All right, perfect. Yes, so yes. Question one, which restaurant has the slogan, Eat Fresh? I think that was close, but I think Chad Morris and Jack Black got it.
That would be a Subway.
That is correct. 1 point for team two.
Thank you.
Good job, Jack. You did good.
Better than you'll ever do.
All right, question number two. At a wedding, the bride and groom often do this together, often with a decorated silver knife. Right here, Ariana Taylor.
Cut the cake.
That is 1 point for team one.
I think we got the buzzer. I think you're cheating, Alex.
Max, I just want to say I'm real disappointed in the way that we did that question.
And I'm disappointed in the Arkansas football program. So, moving on. Number three, celebrate St. Patrick's Day by wearing this color. You buzzed it a little bit too early, so I'm going to give it to the girls
That was confident.
I'm fearless about this one, yeah. The answer is green. They
green
wear
is
green.
Correct. That is another point for team one.
Even though my album's name is red, I recognize other colors.
Cool. All right. So, question four, what TV show is about a paper company out of Scranton, Pennsylvania? Team two.
Alex or Max, whatever your name is, the answer, it's The Office.
It is The Office. That is a point
nice
for
job,
team
man.
Two.
Nice job, Sight.
Okay, Jack.
Moving on, number five, Beyonce has more than 220 million followers on this app, which its icon looks like a Polaroid. Right here, Jeepers. Ariana, I know you're famous on it too, so go ahead.
Instagram.
That is correct.
Thank you, next.
That is a point for team one.
Disappointed.
Question six, in 2013, this Facebook CEO ranked first on a list of the world's highest rated CEOs.
That was Jack.
That was Mark the Zuckerberg.
Was Zuck.
The Zuck.
Good answer.
Yes. The Zuck.
That is a point for team number two, moving on. Question seven, what is the total number of digits on all hands and feet? I think that was team one over here.
10. Total number on hands and feet? Yeah. Oh, 20.
Then. Oh, no.
Wrong at first, so we're going to let team two
Taylor.
Have a chance to steal.
This would be a 20.
That is correct. Yes. That is a point for team
good
two.
Taylor thank can you. Sing. She might not be that smart.
I can
though.
Sing. And I know my colors, red.
Cool. All right. So, what day of the week is known by many as Hump Day?
That would be
Jack.
Miraculous.
Jack.
Miraculous.
Jack, do you mind if I answer this one?
Go ahead.
The answer is Wednesday.
That is correct.
Also Miraculous in Spanish.
Yes, that is correct for team number two. Team one, pick it up a little bit. I think, Taylor, you're going to know this one. This male actor is known for some of his iconic roles in Nightcrawler, Prisoners, Donnie Darko, and even Spider-Man Far From Home. Team two. Yeah.
Jake Gyllenhaal?
That is correct.
Thank you.
I wiped him from my memory.
Sorry. Sorry about that one.
I don't know who that man is.
Question 10. Last one. This one-syllable city has an old saying that goes, this city wasn't built in a day. Team two.
Chad, I'm going to let you answer this one.
Jack, I don't know the answer to this one.
I'm gonna go a Rome, Alex.
They did in fact get it. Team two with another point, and that is all we have for tonight. Okay. I think it is a clear team two sweep on this one. Sorry, Ariana and Taylor. But join us next week as we have Sam Pittman, Pete Davidson, Jake Gyllenhaal, and Kim Kardashian. Thank you and goodbye.
Thank you for watching the final countdown. For all of my classmates and for Sports TV Production 1, I am Alex Altman.